Hey, we've got Jackson Murphy, our favorite Capital Region movie reviewer here with us to find some stuff to watch this weekend because we need to keep everybody busy. You know, otherwise people will be snooping under the tree for gifts. Jackson, I bet you're a snooper, aren't you?
Yes, I'm looking. I'm hunting for the greatest gifts, the greatest DVDs or calendars. I love getting the movie-related calendars every Christmas.
All right.
That's good. Okay, well, what movies can we watch this weekend?
Soul is the brand new Pixar movie that is debuting on Disney Plus for families this Friday, Christmas Day. And it stars the voice of Jamie Foxx. He voices a band teacher who loves jazz, loves playing the piano, gets the opportunity of a lifetime. He's in New York City. So after he gets the gig, he falls into a pothole. That's what happens in New York City. And then all of a sudden, he gets taken to where people go when they die, where people go before they're born, how they get their personalities, learns all of that. It's a little crazy. It's ambitious. This is a very ambitious film for Pixar. It mixes comedy with heart, some drama, some emotion, some career advice. It's all in there. It's got something for everybody. One of your leading contenders for animated feature awards this season, Soul on Disney Plus.
Oh, I'm an emotional wreck already. What other things you got this weekend? That one sounds pretty good. So we got that on Christmas Day.
Right. We've got that. Now, starting today on Netflix, you can watch George Clooney in The Midnight Sky. This is a film he not only stars in, but directs. It's based on a novel. He plays a guy, a researcher who's stationed in the Arctic Circle, and it's the end of the world. And all of a sudden, everybody has to leave, but he stays along with this stowaway little girl, and he doesn't know why she's there, and they have to make it to other locations. It's sci-fi. There's an astronaut subplot in this. This is also playing in theaters at the Bowtie Cinemas in Schenectady for another day or two, and Saratoga through the weekend, because they just reopened last Friday, December 18, those two Bowtie locations.
Oh, that's awesome. So you can take your pick and see it either way you want.
That is correct.
And yeah. I heard George's hair isn't so good in here, but it has nothing to do with the Flo-Bee.
The Flo-Bee, yes, he's got a full beard in this. Yes, a little different, especially for the ladies to look at George. Yeah.
Okay. And what else you got, Jackson?
Well, a similar-ish story with Tom Hanks in his new movie, News of the World, which you can see exclusively in theaters. This is set post-Civil War. He plays a guy who goes around to all different towns in the South, and he reads the headlines from the newspapers. Tom Hanks has said he would love this job. I would love that job back then. Really cool. But then he finds this little girl who's missing, not where she needs to be, not at her home. And so he needs to take her there on this sort of journey as well, even dealing with a bunch of enemies during that time. It's a solid Tom Hanks performance. He reteams with Paul Greengrass. They did Captain Phillips back in 2013. And there is a shootout sequence in this that is one of the cinematic highlights of the year.
Wow. Wow. That sounds pretty good too. Well, we got busy. Lots of movies to watch.
There are lots of movies. And one more is Wonder Woman 1984, which everybody's going to be talking about on social media. I'm looking forward to seeing this. It's in theaters and on HBO Max starting Friday. It is the sequel to 2017's Wonder Woman. Patty Jenkins back as director. Gal Gadot returns as Wonder Woman. Chris Pine's in this as well again, though if you saw the end of Wonder Woman, maybe you're not so sure why Chris Pine is back, but you've got Kristen Wiig as well. Yeah, this is huge for Warner Brothers to put this out in theaters and on HBO Max simultaneously, really raising the bar for streaming services. Everybody's got something. Prime Video's got a film called Sylvie's Love this weekend. All the streaming services and some theater options for your holiday weekend.
Yeah, I do love going to the theater, but it's nice to have these available at home, especially in these crazy times.
You're absolutely right. I was thinking back in March, what are studios going to do? A lot of studios have direct streaming services, Disney with Disney Plus and Universal is Peacock and all these different ones, and HBO Max for Warner Brothers. Are they going to use them for some of their big movies that they have in the can? And that is correct. It's amazing. I wouldn't have thought a year ago that a Pixar movie would not debut in theaters, but here we are.
Well, Jackson, we appreciate your thoughts on all these movies, and it sounds like we got some good stuff to watch this weekend. Huh?
Yes, absolutely.
That's all right, great. Well, lights-camera-jackson.com, Twitter at LCJ Reviews, Instagram at lightscamjackson. And by the way, if you want something for the adults that's holiday-ish, remember that Mel Gibson movie we talked about a little while ago, Fat Man? That's still available on VOD to get you in a different kind of holiday spirit.
Oh, gosh.
I'm frightened right now.
No, thank you.
All right. May you get lots of DVDs in your stocking, Jackson.
Thank you so much. Happy holidays, everybody.
You too. Talk to you later.